Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the best multiple choice questions from the first week of May, that is from 1st of May to 6th of May. The MCQs of 7th of May I have not covered in this, that I will be covering in the second video. And one more thing, these videos are very important for SBI PO Mains, Bank of Baroda, and the quality of questions in this particular video is the best in the past 4 months that I have seen. So do this video nicely, you can expect around 20% of the paper from this video itself. Another thing, CLAT exam is on 14th of May, I am being told, and therefore I will bring to you the second week of May a little earlier, maybe on 13th of morning, something like that, so that the students who are appearing for CLAT 2017, they do the second week video also. And if you want to follow me on Facebook, the link is in the description below. And these are our pen drive courses, Railways, SSC, CGL, CLAT, Hotel Management, BBA, IBPS PO Clerk, SBI PO Clerk. If you want to buy any of our pen drive courses, then you have to dial this number. We are launching our UPSC pen drive course on 1st of Jan and the bookings will start on 1st of June and the booking will start on 15th of May. So that's the number, and I'm giving you one more number, 7291059476, in case this number is engaged because of heavy demand of some of the courses. So let's begin. Which union ministry is observing a fortnight long Swachhta Pakhwada from May the 1st, 2017. Now, this Swachhta Pakhwada, there'll be a lot of activities here. Like for example, there'll be a seminar on the theme of waste to wealth, how you can convert the waste to wealth. And our this ministry is Ministry of Textile. And our Union Minister for Textile is Smriti Irani, who was earlier the HRD minister. And also there'll be films that will be showcased during this Swachhta Pakhwada. These films will be made by students from NIFT. What is the name of the initiative that is launched by Google to help developers and entrepreneurs in smaller cities? This initiative by Google is called Solve for India, and Google wishes to help 10,000 developers and entrepreneurs in India in the smaller cities by giving them technical advice on how to grow businesses. Scientists at IIT Roorkee, they have created inexpensive, that is cheap and more efficient solar cells using which fruit? This fruit is called jamun. And they believe that there is a pigment which occurs in this fruit, and with that pigment they can make dye sensitized solar cells, which are also called Gretzel cells. Gretzel cells are the cells that are made using jamun, and these are very, very important dye sensitized solar cells. And this particular information was published in the Journal of Photovoltaics. Who recently won the Barcelona Open, which is called Con de Godó tennis tournament? Barcelona Open is a very, very important tournament, and this particular player, who is Rafael Nadal, he won it 10th time. So huge achievement. Rafael Nadal overall has won 14 Grand Slams. He has won 9 French Open title, which is, French Open is played on clay, and very soon French Open, Rafael Nadal will be playing, and he will be trying to win it for the 10th time. Now Rafael Nadal is from Spain, remember that. And recently he was beaten in the Australian Open final by Roger Federer, who is from Switzerland. And Andy Murray is from UK. Now, Rafael Nadal beat Dominic Thiem in the final. Dominic Thiem is from Austria. Which team has become the first from the Northeast to win the title at the Hero Indian League? So, Hero Indian League tournament this year was won by Aizwal Football Club. And Aizwal Football Club is from Mizoram. The capital of Mizoram is in fact Aizwal. So, keep that in mind. And the best player, the player who was voted as the best player in the Hero I League was Sunil Chhatri. Sunil Chhatri, and he plays for Bengaluru Football Club. Where was India's second tallest flag post inaugurated recently on the occasion of Maharashtra Day? So first let me tell you, I'm asking you the second tallest flag, but let me tell you where is India's tallest flag. It is at a post called Atari Post, which is on the India-Pakistan border. There we have India's flag 360 foot tall. But this particular flag is second tallest. It is 300 foot. It is in Kolhapur. Our central government has proposed to set up an aerotropolis in which state? So aerotropolis, it is like a metropolitan hub for all the airports. So to monitor all the airport activity, and it will be built in Assam. And it will be built on 2000 acres of land. Assam governor is Banwari Lal Purohit, and Chief Minister is Sarbanand Sonowal of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Which show has won the Best Daytime Drama Series at the 44th Annual Daytime Emmy Awards held at Pasadena? This particular show is called General Hospital. It has won the Best Show Award, and there was another award that you should know, which was for Outstanding Talk Show. So talk shows are shows where a celebrity is called and interviewed, and there are a lot of jokes, a crack like we had in India, like Movers and Shakers and like that. So that is the talk show. So the Best Talk Show or the Outstanding Talk Show Award was given to Ellen DeGeneres show. Ellen DeGeneres is a female. She's very, very popular across the globe. She was also awarded some civilian awards by the outgoing then President Barack Obama. So Ellen DeGeneres show was given the Outstanding Talk Show Award, and General Hospital was given the Best Daytime Drama Series Award. Who has been appointed as the new Controller General of Accounts, CGA? Please note that this is CGA, not CAG. Our CAG is Comptroller and Auditor General. And this position is occupied by Shashikant Sharma. But in the question, they are asking CGA. So that is the Controller General of Accounts. And his name is Anthony Lianzula. Please note that he is the first person from Northeast India to be appointed as the new Controller General of Accounts. Uli Stack passed away recently, and Uli Stack was a famous what? So Uli Stack was a famous mountaineer, and he was from Switzerland. He was also known as Swiss Machine. In fact, he died while he was climbing Mount Nuptse. There is a Mount Nuptse which is very near to Mount Everest. So he was climbing Mount Nuptse and suddenly he died. He was a very, very famous mountaineer. When was International Labor Day celebrated? So this is probably one of the easiest question. International Labor Day celebrated on May the 1st to acknowledge the efforts of labor. Western Railway's first Humsafar Express was flagged off recently by the Railway Minister Suresh Prabhu to run between which two stations? This was Western Railway's first Humsafar Express. But if I ask overall, first Humsafar Express was introduced on December the 16th, 2016 between Gorakhpur, which is in Uttar Pradesh, and Anand Vihar Terminal, which is in Delhi. But Western Railways first will run between Ahmedabad and Chennai. Chennai, as you know, is in Tamil Nadu. Ahmedabad is in Gujarat. World's highest railway bridge is going to be built on which river? It will be inaugurated in 2018. It is called Chenab River Bridge. Chenab is a tributary of River Indus. In fact, it is the largest tributary of River Indus. Another thing, the height of the bridge is 359 meters, which is even more than the height of the Eiffel Tower in France. Speaking of France, France has a new president now, Emmanuel Macron. This I will probably cover in the next week's video. Emmanuel Macron, and he was the ex-advisor to the ex-president or the outgoing president, Francois Hollande. And he beat Le Pen, who was a far-right leader. So Chenab is the answer, and this will be built at an investment of 1100 crore rupees. Now, important question is which two places will be joined by this bridge. So it will connect Jammu with Srinagar. Okay, which place in Jammu? Katra. And exactly which place in Katra? It is Bakkal. So it will connect Bakkal with Kauri. And Kauri is in Srinagar, which is the capital of Kashmir, Jammu and Kashmir. So it will connect Bakkal in Katra in Jammu to Kauri in Srinagar in Kashmir. What is the name of the digital lending platform that has been launched in India by the fintech company called FinMomenta? And it is basically to expand the business to individuals as well as various other businesses. This is called Techie Loans. The word of the month means techie. The meaning of the word techie means fast. It's like fast loans, Techie Loans. Also, they have kept it because it resembles the word tech, since it's a tech company. Tech means technology. So it serves two purposes. Anyways, so fintech companies are in a little bit of trouble right now. I'll give you some extra business knowledge. So for example, Paytm, it is also a fintech company. MobiQuick, all these companies. Fintech means financial technology. Any company that deals with finance and uses technology is a fintech company, right? So Paytm and MobiQuick, their main share of transaction comes from mobile recharge. But what is happening is now the mobile recharge companies like Airtel, Vodafone, etc., they are launching their own apps like Airtel Money, My Vodafone. And also these telecom companies are launching their own payments banks. Like Airtel recently opened its payment bank. Reliance just got the permission to open payment bank. So that is why the number of transactions for mobile recharge on Paytm and MobiQuick are decreasing significantly. And also Paytm, companies like Paytm, they are making heavy losses, crores of rupees of losses, thousands of crores every month, because Paytm is also into a business of e-commerce, electronic shopping, online shopping, and it is making lot of losses because it is giving heavy discounts to consumers and it is burning cash. Third thing, the second highest transactions on Paytm and MobiKwik comes from the Ola and Uber, the taxi aggregator companies, but the margin is very, very less. So it is very difficult to see how these fintech companies will make profit, if at all, in the long run. Now, of course, Paytm company's founder is Vijay Shekhar Sharma. As per the report, now there was a report called Illicit Financial Flows to and from Developing Countries 2005 to 2014 by the Global Financial Integrity. How much of black money entered India during 2005 to 2014? So this 10-year period was the same period coinciding with the UPA1 and UPA2 government in India, that is the Congress government in India. So how much black money came in India in the 10 years, 2005 to 2014, as per the Global Financial Integrity? Very, very important. Now, give you the figures. The money which came into India is $770 billion. Okay, $1 billion is 6700 crore rupees. If you take the value of $1 is equal to 67 rupees, which is right now the case. And how much money went outside from India to other country? Black money, $165 billion exited India during 10 years. Another figure I am giving you, very surprisingly. India's total trade, okay, 14% of that is black money. So this shows how much black money we have in India. Hollywood movie, The Black Prince, which was awarded the Special Jury Remy Award at the 50th annual World Fest Houston International Film Festival, is a biopic on the life of which famous ruler of Punjab? Let me tell you, he was the last king of Punjab and his name is Maharaja Daleep Singh. And the director of the movie is Kaviraj. Kaviraj is the director. And this movie features Shabana Azmi, who is wife of Javed Akhtar and mother of Farhan Akhtar. Another thing, one more person acted in this movie. His name is Satinder Sartaj. And he is a very famous singer from Punjab, Satinder Sartaj. So the name of the movie is Maharaja Daleep Singh. Tariq Mansoor and Pardesi Lal, they have been appointed as the new vice chancellors of which Indian universities? So Tariq Mansoor is the new vice chancellor of Aligarh Muslim University. Aligarh is in Uttar Pradesh. And Pardesi Lal is of Nagaland University. So the answer is 3 and 4. Now my first question for you today. Okay, it's a difficult question. Now there was a movie which was called Aligarh. The name of the movie was Aligarh. It was about a homosexual professor who committed suicide. Or it is not very clear whether he really committed suicide or he was killed. And this professor had to face a lot of trouble for being homosexual. I have not seen the movie, but you have to tell me two questions. One is, this movie Aligarh was based on the life of which famous professor from Aligarh Muslim University? And second question is, who played the role of that professor in the movie? These two questions write down in comments. What is India's position in the ICC T20 rankings? Although such questions are never asked in the exam because these rankings keep changing every week. But still, for current affairs sake, it needs to be covered. India has dropped two places now. India was second, but now India is fourth. So which are the three countries which are before India? First is, of course, New Zealand, performing brilliantly in T20. Second country is England, and third is Pakistan. India is fourth. April the 2nd has been dedicated by the United Nations to which fish? Now, United Nations Secretary General is Antonio Guterres, who is from Portugal, and he was the ex-Prime Minister of Portugal. April 2nd has been dedicated for the fish tuna. Tuna is a very important fish because it constitutes almost 8% of the fish trade. And if you talk about in terms of value, then 20% of all the fishes caught of the value percentage is tuna. That is how important tuna is for the global consumption. And it was celebrated as the first World Tuna Day. So tuna is very important. Those who eat non-veg fish will know tuna. As per the proposed rules of the National No-Fly List, how many levels of unruly behavior by a passenger have been defined? See, there was a case, you know, last month when Ravindra Gaikwad, a politician from Shiv Sena party, he misbehaved with the cabin crew of Air India. So now what has been happening is there are proposed rules and they are on three levels. First level is you will be suspended for 3 months. Second level is you will be suspended for 6 months. Third level is you will be suspended for 2 years or more. These are the three levels that have been defined by DGCA, which will be the nodal agency for implementing these rules. What is DGCA? Directorate General for Civil Aviation. And please note that our Civil Aviation Minister is Ashok Gajapati Raju. And our Minister of State for Civil Aviation is Jayant Sinha. If you remember earlier, Jayant Sinha was the Minister of State for Finance, but now he is Minister of State for Civil Aviation. And Jayant Sinha is, of course, the son of Yashwant Sinha, our ex-finance minister during the BJP government in 2002, way back in Atal Bihari Vajpayee time. He was a finance minister also, and he was then later given charge of External Affairs Ministry also. So he's a Harvard pass out. So that these things you should know. How much amount has been sanctioned or allotted by the central government for paying the pending salaries of primary teacher in Jammu and Kashmir? Jammu and Kashmir is a coalition government of PDP, People's Democratic Party, and BJP. So the ruling party is, of course, the PDP, which is a Mehbooba Mufti. She is the chief minister, and 200 crore is the amount which the center has released because the salaries of the primary teachers has not been paid. Who is leading the Indian delegation at the 27th session of the Universal Periodic Review Working Group being held in Geneva? So Geneva is in Switzerland. There is a Universal Periodic Review 27th session, and Indian delegation will be led by Mr. Mukul Rohatgi. And who is Mukul Rohatgi? He is the Attorney General of India. Now my second question for you today. Who is the Solicitor General of India? Mukul Rohatgi is a Attorney General, all right. But who is the Solicitor General of India? Write down in comments. Prabhat Kamal Bezborua has been appointed as the first non-IAS chairman of what? So he has been appointed as the chairman of T Board of India. Please note that in the world, maximum T is in China. Second maximum is in India. Okay. Highest producer of tea in the world is China, then it is India. Another thing, tea, if they ask where in India, maximum tea is there, it is Assam. State, okay, if they ask city, it is Darjeeling. But Darjeeling is not in Assam, it is in West Bengal. Keep that in mind. And if they ask about Coffee Board of India chairman, then it is Mr. M.S. Bhoje Gowda. M.S. Bhoje Gowda is the chairman of Coffee Board of India. And if they ask in India which state has maximum coffee, it is of course Karnataka. World's biggest X-ray laser. It is around 3.4 kilometer long. It has generated its first beam of light. Now, this particular world's biggest X-ray laser is located in the underground tunnel in which country? It is located in the underground tunnel of Germany. Germany's chancellor is Angela Merkel. Germany's capital is Berlin. Which city has been ranked dirtiest in India in the Swachh Sarvekshan 2017 launched by Urban Development Ministry in January? Swachh Sarvekshan. Which means, so 434, cities were ranked on the basis of cleanliness. 32nd was Varanasi, which is Pradhan Mantri Modi's Lok Sabha constituency. The dirtiest city in India is Gonda. Gonda is in Uttar Pradesh. In fact, in the bottom, bottom list, you know, from the bottom, 25 cities are there from UP, which are the dirtiest. Now let's talk about the best cities or the cleanest cities. Indore is the cleanest city in India. Then Bhopal, both are in Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh government has done phenomenal work in cleanliness. Visakhapatnam then third in Andhra, which has a Telugu Desam party government. And Visakhapatnam is right there at the coast. Surat in Gujarat, then Mysuru. See, Mysuru was used to top the charts in the first few search surveys or these cleanliness surveys. Mysuru was always there at the top. But this time it has slipped to fifth position. Mysuru is in Karnataka. Karnataka is led by a Congress government in the form of Siddaramaiah. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, which is called CCEA, it has given its approval for restructuring the scheme under the new Central Sampada for the period from 2016 to 20. The scheme comes under which union ministry? What is Sampada? See, it's a big full form. You don't need to remember, but still try to remember. Okay, it is Scheme for Agro-Marine Processing and Development of Agro-Processing Cluster, in short Sampada. And this scheme is has an allocation of 6,000 crore rupees and total investment will be 31,400 crore rupees. This scheme comes under the Ministry of Food Processing Industry. And Food Processing Minister is Harsimrat Kaur Badal. Harsimrat Kaur Badal is the Food Processing Industry. And Consumer Affair comes under the Ministry of Consumer Affair. That is the Department of Ram Vilas Paswan. Food Consumption and all. So there are differences. And Agriculture Minister is Radha Mohan Singh. So don't confuse all the three. There was a 3-day long India Integrated Transport and Logistics Summit, which is called IITLS 2017. It was organized by Ministry of Road Transport, that is called MORTH in short. So it was recently held where? It was held in New Delhi. And who is our Minister for Road Transport? Nitin Gadkari is our Minister for Road Transport. According to Asian Development Bank, what will be India's growth rate in 2017? So Asian Development Bank is a Japan-dominated bank. Japan calls the shots because it is by the effort of Japan. Although it is a multi-country bank. A lot of countries are part of Asian Development Bank, but it is dominated by Japan. And therefore, the president of this bank is Takehiko Nakao, who is a Japanese. See, in Asian Development Bank, the president will always be Japanese. Just like in AIIB, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, the president will always be a Chinese because it is dominated by China. So according to Asian Development Bank, in 2017, we will grow by a healthy 7.4%. But in 2018, we will grow by a healthier 7.6%. Okay? And headquarter of Asian Development Bank is in Manila, which is the capital of Philippines. Please note that the president of Philippines is Rodrigo Duterte. Very animated character who doesn't know what he is speaking. Anyways, Rodrigo Duterte, by the way, he won the Forbes Most Influential Person of the Year award. Rodrigo Duterte, Most Influential Personality of the Year. So keep all these things in mind. Which non-banking financial company or microfinance institution has bagged the Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises MSME Banking Excellence Award 2016 in the category Best NBFC MFI for Promotional Schemes? Award is given by the CIMSME. Now, CIMSME is Chamber for Indian Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. Okay, so don't get scared by this big name. It is Chamber for Indian Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. And this company is the Village Financial Services. Please note that it is the first ISO certified microfinance company in India. Which variety of mangoes in Andhra Pradesh has received a geographical indication tag? See, if any fruit receives a geographical indication tag, it means its intellectual property is secured now. It is covered under the intellectual property rights. And a lot of fruits and other things are covered under the geographical indication. For example, just last year, Changali Kudan banana of Kerala and all these things were covered. So now in Andhra Pradesh, there is a very famous mango which is called the Banganapalli mango. Okay, it is protected and by intellectual property, right? This is also called Safeda Aam in North India. Safeda Aam means mango, okay. But it has other names also. Like it is called Chappatai. It is also called Baneshan. Baneshan, Chappatai, Safeda or Banganapalli. All these names are of mangoes from the Andhra. Dronacharya Award. It is given to exceptional coaches. Okay. Dronacharya Award. And Arjuna Award is given to the players. Arjuna Award is for athletes, for players basically. And their coaches receive Dronacharya Award. So which Dronacharya Award winning coach? His name is Captain Chandroop. Basically, the name they have given, Captain Chandroop. But he was a coach for what? So he was for weightlifting. He was himself a weightlifter. He was from Haryana. Which city is likely to get India's first ever blind football academy? Blind football academy is for the blind people or the visually impaired people. It will be set up in Kochi in Kerala. Kerala has a Communist Party of India Marxist government. Pinarayi Vijayan is the chief minister. World Asthma Day is organized by the Global Initiative for Asthma GINA in May every year on the first what? Please note that every first Tuesday of May is the World Asthma Day. Asthma affects more than 25 crore people in the world. Can you believe it? And 2.5 lakh people, they die of asthma every year. Asthma is a disease of the respiratory system in which the hypersensitized trachea, it has allergy to pollen grain, dust, etc. And a person is not able to breathe. In fact, in asthma, the inhaling process is relatively easier because the inhaling is an active process. So you can apply energy and inhale. But the exhaling is a passive process. Therefore, exhaling becomes even more difficult. President Pranab Mukherjee recently attended the annual convocation of Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy. Where is Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy? This is an easy question. Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy is in Dehradun, which is the capital of Uttaranchal. Uttaranchal has a BJP government. Chief Minister is Trivendra Singh Rawat. Another thing, there is another institute which is asked in exam. Central Dairy Research Institute, the place I visited 2 days back in Karnal. So remember Karnal. Karnal is the city of Kalpana Chawla, the famous astronaut from India. Okay. And Karnal is also the city of the Lord Karna from Mahabharata. Gujarat recently celebrated its foundation day. Gujarat was formed on May the 1st, alright, but on which in which year? So Gujarat was formed in the year 1960. And Gujarat, you know, the foundation day is celebrated as Gujarat Gaurav Divas, which means Gujarat Pride Day. So, and Gujarat is also called a jewel of Western India. And Gujarat Chief Minister is Vijay Rupani. Scientists at the University of Alaska Fairbanks have solved the mystery of blood fall that sea from Taylor Glacier into Lake Bonin in Antarctica. This study was published in which journal? This study was published in the Journal of Glaciology. Please note, glaciology is the study of glacier. Glaciers are the big rock or the big fragments of ice that float in the ocean and give rise to lakes. Okay. Now, the biggest glacier in India is, I'll tell its name later. Anyways, first let me tell you about this question, that is blood fall. So in Antarctica, there is a lake called Lake Bonney. Now in this lake, it was observed that some blood-like water comes sometimes. And it was there were a lot of stories behind it. But now this particular mystery has been solved. And the secret was iron minerals. There were some iron minerals which are red in color, and they used to come in the water, and people used to think these are blood falls. These blood falls were discovered in the year 1911, and they have remained a mystery only till now, 2017, when scientists have solved this mystery. Now, India's highest glacier, that you have to write in comments. One hint I will give you. It is bigger than Bathura Glacier. Okay. It is even bigger than Biafo Glacier. Okay. And it is one of the highest post in India where more soldiers from India and Pakistan die because of climate than because of war. Now, can you name the highest glacier of India? Write down in the comment. 2 day long, fourth edition of National Standard Conclave was held where? It was organized by the Bureau of Indian Standard and Confederation of Indian Industry and things like that. So it was a 2 day long fourth edition. It took place in, of course, New Delhi. What is the name of the world's largest telescope, which passed its final test at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center and slated to launch in 2018. The name which has been given to it is Webb, W-E-B-B, after James Webb, the great scientist. And another thing, it will replace the famous Hubble telescope of NASA. Hubble telescope has done a lot of discoveries. Telescope is an instrument with which we see the faraway objects. And the NASA's observatory is built at a cost of $8.8 billion. NASA's headquarters is in Washington, D.C., which also has the headquarter of World Bank and IMF. What is the name of the blind Indian immigrant who was chosen as one of the 14 people to light the torch at Israel's 69th Independence Day celebrations? Recently, Israel 69 Independence Day was celebrated. Israel capital is Jerusalem. One of the closest friends of India is Israel. Israel has Jews. And Israel Prime Minister is Benjamin Netanyahu. These are three favorite questions from Israel. But now they can also ask the currency of Israel, which is the new shekel. New shekel is the currency of Israel. And this person is blind, but he was chosen to light the torch at the Israel's Independence Day. His name is Dina Simata. And Dina Simata is from Manipur. The same place from where Mary Kom is there, Manipur. One IP, two dispensary. It is under the ESI scheme. It was launched by whom? It was launched by our Minister for Labor, Bandaru Dattatreya. And it was launched on the occasion of 1st May, which is the Labor Day. JP Nadda is our Health Minister. Ram Vilas Paswan, I have told you, consumer food and all that. Venkaiya Naidu is for Urban Development and Information Broadcasting both. So these are the things that you should know. Which country is going to launch its own encyclopedia to take on Wikipedia and Britannica? Which country is launching its own encyclopedia? This country is China. And China wants to have some stake in the cultural space also. So China's president is Xi Jinping. China's currency is yuan or renminbi. And China's capital is Beijing, which is the headquarter of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. And China has another very important city called Shanghai, which is the headquarter of the BRICS Bank, also called New Development Bank. Antyodaya Anna Yojana. It is basically the meals will be given at affordable prices or very cheap prices to which, it is launched by which state government? It is launched by the Haryana government. Manohar Lal Khattar is the chief minister. Reserve Bank of India has fixed the rate of interest for 6 months on floating rate bonds. At what percent? They have fixed it at 6.3%. And Reserve Bank of India, the governor is Urjit Patel. Who has won the prestigious 2016 Wisden MCC, that is Melbourne Cricket Council, Cricket Photograph of the Year? Cricket Photograph of the Year was shot by Saqib Majid. Saqib Majid is in fact the first Kashmiri, and he is only the second Asian to win this honor. First Asian to win was Atul Kamble, also an Indian, Atul Kamble. SGDC and KoreaSat 7 satellites were recently launched into the space by which rocket from European Space Agency's spaceport in Kourou, French Guiana. In French Guiana, European Space Agency's rocket you have to name, the rocket name is Ariane the 5th. And please note that KoreaSat satellite is from Korea, but SGDC is a Brazilian satellite. Ali Uld Muhammad Wal passed away recently. He was the former president of which country? Let me give you some hint. And I bet still you will not be able to recall. Okay. So let's say capital of this country is Nouakchott. Okay. Capital of this country is Nouakchott. And the currency of this country is Oguyeya. Okay. So this country is the Mauritania. Appointments committee recently appointed the managing director and chief executive officer of how many public sector banks? How many government banks have now new managing director and CEO? So this question is supremely important. These are 7 banks. And let me tell you the most important one. So Usha Ananta Subramaniam, one of the most powerful women in India. She was earlier the managing director and CEO of Punjab National Bank, but now not. Now she is of Allahabad Bank. Allahabad Bank new managing director and CEO is Usha Ananta Subramaniam. Then Indian Overseas Bank new MD and CEO is R. Subramaniam Kumar. Bank of India, it is Mr. Dina Bandhu Mohapatra. Union Bank of India is Mr. Raj Kiran Rai. Punjab National Bank, Usha Ananta Subramaniam has been replaced by Sunil Mehta. Vijaya Bank, it is R. K. Shankarana Narayana. And Syndicate Bank, it is Mr. M. O. Rego. These are the 7 new managing directors and CEOs of the public sector bank, especially important for all the banking exams. Which state government has tied up with World Health Organization for eradication of rubella and measles? For rubella measles, we have a vaccine also which is called MMR. It is for measles, for rubella, and this M stands for mumps. Mumps is a swelling of the parotid gland. And this state is Maharashtra, which is a coalition government of Shiv Sena and Bharatiya Janata Party. Chief Minister is Devendra Fadnavis. 8th Conference of Head of Missions was recently inaugurated in New Delhi by which Union Minister? It was inaugurated by Sushma Swaraj, who recently had a kidney transplant and was not very active into the Ministry of External Affairs. And that's all you need to know. India Integrated Transport and Logistics Summit, IITLS, was recently held where? It was organized by the Ministry of Road Transport and Heavy Building, that is MORTH. It was organized in New Delhi. National Green Tribunal. So National Green Tribunal is basically a court which looks into matters pertaining to environment. If you are not happy with the decision of NGT, you can approach the Supreme Court. NGT has announced a fine of how much amount on electronic waste if we dump it into River Ganga. So you will be fined 1 lakh rupees. And the head of National Green Tribunal is Justice Swatantra Kumar. Justice Swatantra Kumar, he has been in fact the head of National Green Tribunal ever since its inception. Justice Swatantra Kumar. UP government has announced to celebrate UP Divas each year on which day? They will celebrate the UP Day on January the 24th because this is on, you know, it is on this day that the United Province was called Uttar Pradesh in 1950. Which Indian multinational company is going to hire 10,000 Americans in the next 2 years? This company is investing a lot in artificial intelligence. And World Bank has said that 69% of jobs in India are threatened because of artificial intelligence or robotics. And in fact, this country fired 9,000 Indian engineers last year, but now it is hiring 10,000 Americans. This country is Infosys. And the CEO of Infosys is Vishal Sikka. Vishal Sikka is the CEO of Infosys. Which space agencies are planning to collaborate on building the first moon village? Which 2 space agencies? It is the China National Space Agency, which is called CNSA, and European Space Agency. So the answer is 1 and 4. Together, they want to build Moon Village. And ISRO is headquartered in Bengaluru. The chairman of ISRO is A.S. Kiran Kumar. It is India's space agency. NASA is America's space agency, headquartered in Washington, D.C. One more they ask in exam, which is Roscosmos. Roscosmos is Russia's space agency. And there is one more, Japanese Aeronautical Exploration Agency, also called JAXA, J-A-X-A. Which university recently conferred the degree of Doctor of Letter Honoris Causa on Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan? So Erdogan is an interesting fellow. Just few weeks back, he was the Prime Minister of Turkey, but then there was a constitutional amendment and Turkey shifted from parliamentary democracy to executive presidency. So President is now the most powerful person in the Turkey. And he was recently on a visit to India. And the university that gave him the degree of Doctors of Letters is the Jamia Millia Islamia. Jamia Millia Islamia. And please note that Jamia Millia Islamia Chancellor is Lieutenant General M. A. Zaki. International Firefighters Day was observed where? So the people who basically extinguish the fire, protect people, their contribution has to be recognized. And for that, International Firefighters Day is celebrated on May the 4th. Who won the World Snooker Championship 2017? He was the firm favorite because he's world number one player. And his name is Mark Selby. There is a set of four children's books which is called Swachh Jungle Ki Kahani, Dadi Ki Zubani, which means these are the grandmom stories which your grandmom used to tell you in your childhood. These are the stories pertaining to the forest, like the Jungle Book, etc. Anyways, so there are four children's books and they were released by the Ministry of Information Broadcasting. Information Broadcasting Minister is Venkaiah Naidu. So in how many languages these were released? These were released in 15 languages. 15 languages. New Expressionist painter A.R. Penck. Expressionism was one of the very famous events in Europe at one point of time. So New Expressionist painter A.R. Penck passed away. He was from which country? He was from Germany. And please note, his real name was not A.R. Penck, but his real name was Ralph Winkler. Archaeologist, they have found something. They have found the remains of a model garden that dates back roughly 4,000 years. Outside a tomb in which Egyptian city? Egypt's capital is Cairo, and there are a lot of secrets in Egypt like pyramid and all that. Now there is an Egyptian city called Luxor. In that, scientists have found these remains of a model garden. India recently conducted an unsuccessful test firing of which medium range nuclear capable missile from Dr. Abdul Kalam Island? See, Dr. Abdul Kalam Island is the new name for Wheeler Island in Odisha, Chandipur, Odisha. Okay. This was an unsuccessful fire from India because this missile was not able to meet the desired parameter. This is the Agni second, which has a 2000 kilometer capacity. That is the range of the Agni missile. 2000 kilometer. Agni 2. It is a surface-to-surface missile. Number of awards in the category of voluntary organization. You know, earlier there was only one award given, under the National Youth Award by the Sports Ministry. And who is our sports minister? Vijay Goyal. He is the Minister of Sports, Minister of State for Sports and Youth Affairs with independent charge. Vijay Goyal. Okay. So previously there was only one award which was given. Now the number of awards in the voluntary organization category has been increased to what? Number of awards will be given will be 10. And total how many people will be presented the award? 25. And prize money has also been increased. It is now 2 lakh rupees. And in the individual category, it is 50,000 rupees. 8 state assembly have passed the goods and services tax bill. Which of the following is not one of them? See, goods and services tax, it is an indirect tax which will replace all the sales taxes. And goods and services tax needs to be implemented by at least 15 states for it to be qualified as a law. Okay, goods and services tax. So now the thing is, 8 states have passed it. Which of the following is not one of them? Haryana recently passed it, Uttarakhand did too, Madhya Pradesh did too, so the answer is Karnataka. My third question for you today, which was the first state to pass the GST bill? Write down in comments. Union Cabinet recently gave the ex post facto approval to the signing of a Ministry of Cooperation, Memorandum of Cooperation, which is MOC. See, there are many these words, MOU, MOA, and MOU, MOC, and all that. Okay, we'll see. So MOC is called Memorandum of Cooperation with Japan in the field of what? Japan will cooperate in the field of railway safety. See, Japan is a master of railways. It has a lot of bullet trains also. Now, there is a very famous bullet train in Japan, which is called Shinkansen. This is the same train in which Narendra Modi was roaming around with Shinzo Abe last year. And Japan will help India in railway safety. Another thing, we have signed a Memorandum of Understanding, MOU, with Malaysia. Malaysia, truly Asia. Okay. Malaysia, we have signed it in the field of manufacturing of urea and ammonia. Urea and ammonia. Ammonia is what you call NH3. And the third MOU, an important one, we have signed with Spain. We have signed it for civil aviation. And our minister for civil aviation is Ashok Gajapati Raju. World's largest particle smasher LHC. It has restarted circulating beams of protons for the first time in 2017 because it was not working after December 2016. It is the world's largest LHC. What is LHC? It is the Large Hadron Collider. H-A-D-R-O-N. Hadron Collider is a machine. It is developed by the scientists from the CERN, which is called the European Organization for Nuclear Research. And it took 10 years to build it. And it is kept in a 27 kilometer tunnel which connects which two countries? It connects France with Switzerland. So the answer is France and Switzerland. Which electronic commerce or online shopping company has acquired on-demand household service provider Zimber for $10 million? By the way, one of the founders of Zimber is my classmate. So I'm feeling very proud that his company is sold for $10 million. Anyways, this company is acquired by Quikr. It was an all-stock deal. And the company is founded by Gaurav Srivastav, who was my classmate, Anubhav Goyal and Amit Kumar. And Quikr, of course, its CEO is Pranay Kulet. And headquarter is in Bengaluru. Zimber headquarter is in Mumbai. Where has India's first private small arms manufacturing plant been opened by Punj Lloyd? It is a joint venture with Israel Weapons Industries. So this has been opened in a place called Malanpur. And it is in Madhya Pradesh. Who will be heading the technical committee, which is constituted by the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Bureau of India, to lay down technical standard for the performance of the core and other services under IBPI, Information Utility Regulation 2017. And for that, for laying down this technical standard, there is a committee which has been constituted, and it will be headed by Mr. R.B. Burman. World Press Freedom Day. India slipped further three positions on World Press Freedom Index. It is observed every year on 3rd May to celebrate anniversary of what? It is to celebrate the anniversary of the Windhoek Declaration. And the 2017 theme was Critical Minds for Critical Times. As simple as that. Critical Minds for Critical Times. It was established in 1993. And please note, Windhoek is the capital of Namibia. And why India lags behind in World Press Freedom is because a lot of journalists are murdered for their honest work. Who won both men's single and doubles title at the 2017 ITTF Challenge Chile Open held in Santiago? I'm talking about table tennis. This particular player is Soumyajit Ghosh. He won the singles title, but for doubles, he partnered with another player, and that another player name is Anthony Amal Raj. And Chile capital is Santiago, but the currency of Chile is peso. Who has been appointed as the new chairman of Public Accounts Committee? See, Public Accounts Committee, there are 14 members in the PAC and term of office is only 1 year. So he replaced Mr. K.V. Thomas. His name is Mallikarjun Khadge. He was appointed by the Lok Sabha Speaker. Which of the following companies recently released its new brand identity? This, just mug it up. The company is Wipro. And who is the CEO of Wipro? It is into a lot of fields like FMCG, fast moving consumer good, IT business is also there, and a lot of things it manufactures, Wipro. So I'm asking, who is the CEO of Wipro? His name is Abidali Namuchwala. What will be India's growth rate as per SCAP, which is the UN Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific? India will grow by healthy 7.1%. 7.1% still it is looking less, because they say that India's policies will be affected by US, and US will try to block India's growth, and I mean all those things are there. So this report was called the Economic and Social Survey of Asia and the Pacific 2017. But they also said that in 2018 we will grow by a healthy 7.5%. As per the modified list for Odisha, which of the following communities have been notified as scheduled caste? So which community in Odisha is now included under the scheduled caste? It is the Sualgiri. Sualgiri, also written sometimes as Sualgiri. Odisha has a Biju Janata Dal party and Chief Minister is Naveen Patnaik. Which state has become the first to adopt the January to December financial year? See, right now the financial year in India starts from 1st of April, it ends in 31st of March, and this was given to us by the British government in 1867. So they say that keep the things that British gave us. Let's have our own financial year, which should start from 1st of Jan, it should end on 31st of December. And the first state to adopt it is the state of Madhya Pradesh. Who won the men's doubles titles? I'm talking about tennis at the Tallahassee Challenger, which was held in Florida, United States. It was the team of Leander Paes along with Scott Lipsky. Okay, so the answer is 1 and 3. Leander Paes, of course, is from India. He won the bronze medal in the 1996 Atlanta Olympics. Leander Paes. Scott Lipsky is from which country? Scott Lipsky is from... I'm not sure actually. So just find out where Scott Lipsky is from. And Leander Paes is new partner. So answer is 1 and 3. E-Nasika and OTL 300 devices have been handed over to the Indian military recently. They have been developed by whom? These devices have been developed by DRDO, Defense Research Development Organization, and the chairman of DRDO is S. Christopher, chairman, president, whatever you may call, S. Christopher, and ISRO is A.S. Kiran Kumar. Remember these two. What is e-Nasika? Nasika means nose, which is used for breathing. So this electronic Nasika, it can, it can basically, it is capable of detecting any chemical agents which are below the toxic limits. And OTL 300, it is a device which can instantly detect any camouflaged optical element. So these will further empower our military men, who has been honored with Tamil Nadu's Avayar Award for 2017. Avayar Award has been given to the daughter of our ex-president, former president of India, the late Dr. R. Venkatraman. His daughter is Padma Venkatraman. And Padma Venkatraman has done a lot of work in women welfare and rehabilitation of leprosy patients. Padma Venkatraman, she is also the chairman of Women's India Association, WIA. Which bank is going to create 600 digital villages in India by the end of 2017 across India? This bank is of course the ICICI Bank. President is Chanda Kochar. And please note one thing, that the first digital village in India was the Akodra village, which is in Sabarkantha district in Gujarat. It was also developed by ICICI Bank. Railways is going to launch luxury trains. So luxury trains means like where you have all the facilities like a 5-star hotel. So a lot of facilities will be provided in this train, like Wi-Fi, like vending machine, ATM, magazines and snacks and LCD TV and all that. Automatic doors will be there. So these trains will be called Tejas Express. But these luxury trains will run on which route? They will run from Mumbai to Goa. And our railway minister is Suresh Prabhu. What is the name of the campaign that has been launched by the Human Resource Development, that is HRD Ministry? Our HRD minister is Prakash Javadekar. And basically this campaign will inculcate patriotism in our young students. This is called the Vidya Virta Abhiyan. Vidya Virta Abhiyan is called Wisdom and Warrior Campaign. W-A-I-I-O-R. Wisdom and Warrior Campaign. So this basically is this. In 1000 schools, there will be a wall which will be built. On the wall, there will be photos of Indian heroes like Paramveer Chakra awardees and all the our martyrs or our war heroes. The photos, this will inculcate patriotism in the students of India. Who bagged the first position in the Formula 1 Russian Grand Prix? Who won the Russian Grand Prix? He's a driver who drives Mercedes. So now it's easy. It is Valtteri Bottas. Valtteri Bottas. Lewis Hamilton, of course, he also drives Mercedes, but this time he did not win. Valtteri Bottas won. Valtteri Bottas, although his name seems Italian, but he's not Italian. He is from Finland. Capital of Finland is Helsinki. What is the amount that is sanctioned by railways for the first phase of equipping all wagons and locomotives with RFID tag? So these RFID tags are also fitted in the, you know, the toll tax on the highways, where there is a prepaid instrument and money is automatically cut from your prepaid card that is fitted on your windscreen. So total 57 crore rupees will be spent, and the price of one RFID tag is 1000 rupees. Dr. Sanjay Pratihar, who has been awarded as Indian National Science Academy Medal for Young Scientist Award, is a faculty member in which university? He is a faculty member in the Tejpur University. Now my fourth question for you today. Where is Tejpur? Which state has Tejpur? Write down in comments. Where was Maharashtra's first automatic weather station inaugurated recently? In fact, it was inaugurated in Nagpur in Dongargaon, which is in the Vidarbha region, Nagpur. And please note that this is not the first. This is the first, but there will be more than 2000 weather stations which will be built up in the entire Maharashtra itself in the public-private partnership model. Who was conferred or bestowed upon with the Grand Collar of the Order of the Makarios III? It is the highest civilian award of Cyprus. Cyprus capital is Nicosia, and the Prime Minister of Cyprus, he was on a 5-day visit to India. So the President of Cyprus. The President of Cyprus is Nikos Anastasiades. Nikos Anastasiades is the president of Cyprus. He was on a 5-day visit to India, and he gave the award to Pranab Mukherjee. India is going to give scholarships worth 35 crore rupees to the children of freedom fighter of which country under the Mukti Jodha scheme? Mukti Jodha scheme is that the freedom fighters of Bangladesh. See, India and Bangladesh, we paired up in the 1971 Bangladesh Liberation War. So India and Bangladesh have been friends ever since. And in the next 5 years, India will spend this much amount to give free scholarships to the children of freedom fighters. And Bangladesh Prime Minister is Sheikh Hasina, who was on a visit to India last month. SpaceX. SpaceX company is of Elon Musk. He is the CEO of SpaceX. So he has launched Enrol 76. It's a classified US intelligence mission. He launched it from which space center? He launched it from Kennedy Space Center. And headquarter of SpaceX is in California. Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi, he recently released a commemorative stamp on the millennial birth anniversary. That is, birth of this gentleman, 1000 years have completed since he took birth, of which 11th century philosopher. His name is Ramanujacharya. He was a saint from the Vaishnavite community. And in fact, his divine body is preserved still in a temple in Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. The temple name is Srirangam Ranganathar Swami Temple. Who has been appointed as the new president of the Confederation of Indian Industry for the financial year 2018. Her name is Shobhana Kamineni. And she is also the executive vice president of Apollo Hospitals. Who has become the first Indian to clinch the title at the 19th Asian Squash Championship which was held in Chennai. Her name is Joshna Chinappa. Remember one more player, Deepika Pallikal. These two players have brought immense fame to India. Deepika Pallikal and Joshna Chinappa. Joshna Chinappa is the first Indian to clinch the title at the 19th Asian Squash Championship held in Chennai. Remember one more name of a squash player. His name is Saurav Ghoshal. Saurav Ghoshal was beaten in the final of the men's single by Max Lee, who is this player from Hong Kong. Which state has launched an ambulance service for cows, which is called Gauvansh Chikitsa Mobile Van. Gauvansh Chikitsa means the healthcare for the cow mobile van that would cater to only and only cows. This was launched by Uttar Pradesh. Now Madhya Pradesh has followed suit. So Madhya Pradesh is the second state to launch ambulance for only cows. So this scheme in Uttar Pradesh is launched in Allahabad, Gorakhpur, Lucknow, Mathura and Varanasi. Governor of Uttar Pradesh is Ram Naik and Chief Minister is of course the animated Yogi Adityanath. Which city has become the first in the world to launch its own typographic font? And this font is released in 23 languages with the help of Microsoft. This is Dubai. Dubai is in United Arab Emirates. It is one of the seven emirates and United Arab Emirates capital is Abu Dhabi. Who was honored with the Order of Diplomatic Service Merit Sangne Medal of South Korea? It was given by Hwang Kao Ahan. He is right now both the President and Prime Minister of Korea. Now you'll ask me how this is possible. This is possible because he is the Prime Minister, all right. But the President, Park Geun-hye, she was impeached by the Parliament. So he is the acting President right now. So he's a very important man because he is the Prime Minister and President both. Hwang Kao Ahan. Because Park Geun-hye was impeached because she was collaborating with some corrupt companies like Samsung and all. Anyways, so who is the Indian diplomat? His name is Rajiv Kaul. What is the name of web portal launched by Department of Telecom that allows the people to track radiation emitted from mobile tower within their locality? So, you know, all these big telecom tower, they also release certain radiations. And these radiations, it's possible that they may not be after a limit useful for the human body or they may not harm the human body. It's possible that they can harm the body. So now you can measure what is the you can track the radiation emitted from your mobile tower within your locality using Tarang Sanchar. Tarang Sanchar means radiation communication, and this is launched by the Department of Telecom. When was Ganga Swachhta Sankalp Divas? Ganga Swachhta means you want basically keep Ganga clean. You want a clean Ganga, and for that you need to do a proper Sankalp. Or you need to be very motivated for that. It is celebrated by the National Mission on Clean Ganga. And the Ganga cleanliness is under the Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. And our minister for that is Uma Bharti of the Bharatiya Janata Party. The day is on May the 2nd. And this program of Ganga Clean is called Namami Gange. Which of the following won the bid of the most expensive limestone block, Kesla 2nd, which is in Chhattisgarh at a price of ₹11,894 crore. Chhattisgarh was in news recently because there was an attack in Sukma on our CRPF jawans. Lot of CRPF jawans got killed. I think 27 got killed in Sukma. And lot of leftist insurgency areas are in Chhattisgarh, like Sukma, Bastar. Chhattisgarh capital is Naya Raipur. And they recently had a bid for this inaugural Kesla 2 block, which was won by the company called Dalmia Bharat. Scientists in which country have successfully built the world's first quantum computing machine? Now this machine can take speeds up to 24,000 times more than your international counterparts. This was developed by China, and China have a very important scientist called Pan Jianwei. He is a renowned quantum physicist. Global credit rating company Fitch Global credit rating company Fitch has kept India's sovereign rating at what? So this rating is called stable. It is BBB negative. Fitch headquarter is in New York. Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, which is a Chinese-dominated bank, please note that after China, this bank has maximum shareholding of India. And it has given a loan of how much for, there is a power project in Andhra Pradesh for that. Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, which is headquartered in Beijing, has given a loan of $160 million. $160 million. And the president of this bank is Jin Liken, who is the ex-finance minister of China. Uber. Uber has debuted its food delivery service, which is called Uber Eats. In which city? They have done it in Mumbai. Now my fourth and most important question for you today. Who is the CEO of Uber? Who is the CEO of Uber? Who has been appointed as the chairman of the Indian Council of Social Science Research, that is called ICSSR? Earlier it was Mr. S.K. Thorat. Now he has been replaced by Mr. Braj Bihari Kumar. India recently conducted a successful test fire of an advanced Block 3 version of which satellite? Which missile, sorry. Successful test firing of BrahMos. Now let me tell you something interesting. BrahMos, there is a river in Moscow. There is a river in Russia which is called Moskva. And Brahma, Bra stands for Brahmaputra. So it is a missile which is built with Russian support. Bra comes from Brahmaputra, B-R-A-H, Bra, and M-O-S comes from Moskva. Okay. So that is our Moskva River in Russia. Pratap Singh Bagal, he passed away recently. He was the former minister of which state? He was a Congress minister in the Madhya Pradesh government under Digvijay Singh. 13th International Permaculture Convergence is going to be held where? International Permaculture Convergence. Its theme is towards healthy society. So this is a health-based conference. It will take place in Hyderabad, the capital of Telangana. There is a 5-country delegation. They are on a visit to India to study EVIN. What is EVIN? EVIN stands for, it is basically the vaccination program, Electronic Vaccine Intelligence Network, EVIN. It is a project of which union ministry? It is a project of health ministry. Our health minister is JP Nadda. And these 5 countries which have come in India, they are Philippines, Indonesia, Bangladesh, Nepal and Thailand. And they want to study India's practice in immunization, which has become one of the best in the world. How many states or union territories signed MOA for the purchase of, see, MOA means a memorandum of agreement, for the purchase of 1000 megawatt wind power with PTC India under MNRE. MNRE is nothing but Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. And our Minister for Power, Coal and Renewable Energy is Piyush Goyal. And this was Ministry of New and Renewable Energy's first wind auction scheme. So total 6 states, they signed memorandum of agreement. Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Delhi, Odisha and Assam. 3 countries have signed a safe zone deal for Syria. Which of the following is not one of those? These 3 countries which have signed a safe zone deal for Syria are Turkey, Iran and Russia. Russia's president is Putin, Iran's Hassan Rouhani, Turkey, Erdogan. And these 3 have signed, that is, if the war in Syria cannot be stopped, at least have some safe zones where the war will be not fought. And United States President Donald Trump of the Republican Party, he also called up Vladimir Putin to discuss about the possibility of the safe zones. Syria's capital is Damascus and Syria's president is Bashar Assad, who is number one enemy of America and close friend of Russia. South Asia satellite of India, which was called the SARC satellite previously, was launched into space on a GSLV rocket from Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. It is also called what? It is called the GSAT-9 and it will cater to all the SARC countries except Pakistan. Pakistan chose not to be a member of South Asia satellite. Which company has launched its program called Express Wi-Fi? It's a very fast internet. For that, they have partnered with various other companies like Air Jaldi in Uttarakhand, Tikona in Gujarat and so on. This company is Facebook. Facebook is now launching Express Wi-Fi in India. They have previously launched it in Indonesia, Tanzania, Kenya, Nigeria, a lot of other countries. But now it wants to see whether this process can be as successful in India as in other countries. Facebook CEO is Mark Zuckerberg and Facebook COO, Chief Operating Officer, is Sheryl Sandberg. Which of the following organizations unveiled a solar hybrid electric car? Who has made in India a car that can be run with solar power also and electricity also? And they have done it with using all the indigenous technology, in-house resources, Indian resources. This is, of course, done by ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization. This car was made at the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, which is in Thiruvananthapuram, capital of Kerala. Scientists in which country have developed world's fastest camera? This camera tech can take 50,000 crore photos in 1 second. That is like, 5 trillion photos in 1 second. This is built by the scientists from Sweden. Capital of Sweden is Stockholm and the currency of Sweden is krona. Cabinet has given its approval to give international status to which airport? Which airport in India will now be called International Airport? It is the Vijayawada Airport. Vijayawada is in Andhra Pradesh. And this is, some provisions have been made in the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act of 2014 to be able to name this, rechristen or rename this airport. There is an exhibition which is called Srishti. Srishti means Safe Road and Interstate Highways Transforming India. In short, Srishti. It was recently inaugurated by which union ministry? So we are talking about road transport here. So it is the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, which comes under Nitin Gadkari. Which company has partnered with SAP to introduce Saral GST? Saral means easy. Easy GST means it's a solution for taxpayer under the GST regime, because everybody may not be able to, you know, fully understand what is GST and how to go about it. So therefore, Saral GST will help these. It has been built by Reliance Corporate IT Park Limited in association with SAP, who has been appointed as the Managing Director, Financial Services by the Bharti Enterprise. Just mug up the name. His name is Souman Ghosh. Ujjivan Small Finance Bank recently started its operations in which city? Ujjivan Small Finance Bank started its operation in Pune. It also has presence in Bengaluru and Ramanagar, Mumbai, New Delhi, Kolkata, apart from Pune. Madhya Pradesh Cabinet recently gave an in-principle approval to granting the status of living human entity to which river? That is, if you hurt this river, if you cause any damage to this river, it will be seen as violation of human rights. So this river is the Narmada River, the largest river in Madhya Pradesh. It also touches Maharashtra, some part of Maharashtra, then it reaches Gujarat, and it is 1312 kilometer long river, which takes its origin from Amarkantak. What is India's position in the new world rankings that have been released by FIFA? FIFA's headquarter is in Zurich. The president of FIFA is Gianni Infantino. Gianni Infantino is an Italian citizen. He also has citizenship of Switzerland. And India's position is 100, which is very healthy, because it's the first time in last 21 years we have reached this high. When is National Anti-Child Labor Day observed? This is basically to prevent children from doing labor which can compromise their childhood. We celebrate on April the 30th. What will be the base year of the new series of Index of Industrial Production, which is going to be launched shortly in India? This was announced by our Chief Statistician and MOSPI Secretary, Mr. TCA Ananta. So, just remember that MOSPI, M-O-S-P-I, it is the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. Its Minister is Sadananda Gowda, who is from Udupi, Karnataka. And what will be the base year? Base year now will be 2011-2012. And what is the previous base year? It is 2004-2005. It will be replaced with 2011-12. What was the highest ever level of carbon dioxide recorded on April 18 at the Mauna Loa Observatory in Hawaii? It is 410 ppm. Carbon dioxide, see, is very, very dangerous because it is a greenhouse gas. It raises the temperature of the atmosphere. And please note that this research was done by the Scripps Institute, S-C-R-I-P-P-S. What is the name of the umbrella program for roads that will be built, that will hit the ground in 6 months, ending all existing highway projects? So basically, the largest ever project for road transport is the NHDP. Okay, National Highway Development Project. 50,000 kilometers of roads were built for this project. But now, it is second highest is Bharatmala. In Bharatmala, 20,000 kilometers of highway will be built. Which of the following is going to be the first to use the plasma technology for eliminating toxic waste? To dispose toxic waste, the Bhilai steel plant in Chhattisgarh, made by Steel Authority of India Limited, will ensure there is a plasma technology so that people can be protected from the toxic waste. Infosys has partnered with which online technology company? Together, they will produce the next generation of ACE coder for its business expansion plan. This is the Tech Gig Code Gladiator online technology community. Meen Bahadur Sherchand, he was the oldest person to climb Mount Everest. Please note that he first climbed Mount Everest when he was 76. His record was then broken. But at the age of 85, he again climbed Mount Everest to regain his record, and he did it. He is from Nepal. Mount Everest is the highest peak, 8,848 meter. And second highest is Kanchenjunga. Actually, second highest is K2, 8611. Third highest is Kanchenjunga, 8598. But if they ask which is the highest peak in India of Himalayas, it is Kanchenjunga, 8598. Because K2 is not in Himalayas. Leela Seth, who was the first woman Chief Justice of a state high court in the country, recently passed away. She headed which high court? Very, very eminent person. In fact, Narendra Modi, Prime Minister himself, tweeted he was shocked to see the demise of Leela Seth. So, Leela Seth is mother of Vikram Seth. Do you know Vikram Seth? He wrote A Suitable Boy. A Suitable Boy book was written by Vikram Seth, and she is the mother of Vikram Seth. So, she was the first woman Chief Justice of India for Himachal Pradesh. She was made the Chief Justice of India for Himachal, becoming the first ever woman. She was also Delhi High Court's first woman judge. She was also first woman to top the London bar exams in 1958. So she has an autobiography also, by the way. The name is On Balance. Shapath Bharadwaj, he's a male. He is related to which sport? So he is related to shooting. And he reached the first ever ISSF World Cup final in Cyprus. Which state has been declared as a disturbed area under the Armed Forces Special Power Act by the central government for 3 more months? Because two organizations, the ULFA and NDFB, they have created havoc and violence in this state. It is the state of Assam. It has been declared as disturbed. Entire state has been declared as disturbed. Third, it is a missile system to protect which country? It has been designed by America and installed in this country. So third missile system has been installed in South Korea to protect it from North Korea, onslaught of North Korea. See, North Korea is number one enemy of America. North Korea does not have an intercontinental ballistic missile. So America is safe. But the missiles which North Korea have, South Africa and Japan, they both are on its radar. 15th World WFH International Musculoskeletal Congress. This is basically a medical and surgical and non-surgical methods to tackle various muscle disorders were discussed here. It was recently in Seoul. India's foreign exchange reserves reached a record high in the week ending the April 28 to how much? India's foreign exchange reserve rose to $373 billion. And in fact, our gold reserves, they were unchanged. But our foreign exchange reserves are now one of the highest. Scientists of which university have developed the world's first soft tissue retina? Retina is the part of eye where image is formed. So it is like the photo film of a camera. So retina, if something happens to retina, God forbid, then you will lose your eyesight. This research was done by scientists of Oxford University who have made world's first synthetic retina. Netra. See, Netra stands for NTPC Energy Technology Research Alliance, which is called Netra. It has installed a photogrammetry system of solar thermal lab. It has been commissioned in cooperation with which country? Netra we have installed, and it is India's first. We have also installed, with the help of this country, India's first indigenously developed high temperature drop tube detector, which is called DTR, with the help of Germany. So both Netra and DTR with the help of Germany. ICC has increased the prize money of 2017 Women's World Cup to be held in England to what? They have increased the prize money 10 times to the last World Cup, which was in 2013 Women's World Cup. So now the prize money is $2 million. So these were the best multiple choice questions. And as you can see, as I told you in the beginning of the video itself, the quality of questions is absolutely fantastic. So this video will go a long way in your preparation. So do share it with your friends. Thanks very much.